हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम रीनल बारड, फैकल्टी ऑफ मणिबाबुला नर्सिंग कॉलेज, उका तड़साड़िया यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट प्रोसीजर ऑफ यूरिनरी कैथेटराइजेशन।
यूरिनरी एलिमिनेशन इज अ नॉर्मल प्रोसेस वेयर बाय यूरिन इज एक्सपेल्ड फ्रॉम द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर। फेलियर ऑफ यूरिनरी एलिमिनेशन रिक्वायर्स मैनुअल इंटरवेंशन टू ड्रेन यूरिन फ्रॉम द ब्लैडर by inserting a catheter into the bladder using sterile technique. Definition: urinary catheterization is the introduction of a catheter into the urinary bladder through urethra using aseptic technique for the purpose of emptying the bladder. Related anatomy and physiology. The urinary bladder is a reservoir of urine. It lies in the pelvic cavity and its size and position vary depending on the amount of urine it contains. When distended, the bladder rises into the abdominal cavity. At urethral orifice, there is thickening of the smooth muscle layer which act as a sphincter and control the passage of urine from the bladder into urethra. The internal sphincter is under autonomic nervous control. The external sphincter guards the external urethral orifice, which is under voluntary control. Maturation occurs when the muscular wall of the bladder contracts. There is reflex relaxation of internal sphincter and the voluntary relaxation of the external sphincter. Length of urethra varies in the female and male patients. Female urethra is 4.5 cm long and male is about 20 cm long. The male urethra is surrounded by the prostate gland at the neck of the bladder. Types of catheterization. First type is intermittent catheterization. It is the insertion and removal of a catheter several times a day to empty the bladder. Second type is indwelling catheterization. It is also known as Foley's catheter. It is left inside the bladder to provide continuous urine drainage. Third type is suprapubic catheterization. It refers to the placement of a drainage tube into the urinary bladder through a surgical incision made in the abdominal wall just above the pubic symphysis. Purposes. Purposes for intermittent catheterization are to relieve bladder distension, to assess for residual urine after voiding, to obtain a sterile specimen, to empty bladder prior to delivery or abdominal surgery. Next, purposes for indwelling catheterization are to facilitate urine elimination in incontinent patients, to facilitate continuous bladder drainage after injury, surgery on urinary tract or other major surgeries, to spleen to urethra to promote healing after urological surgery, to relieve acute or chronic urinary retention, to prevent urine from contacting an incision after perineal surgery. Indication of catheterization. First, acute retention of urine in male patients with prostatic enlargement. Then chronic retention of urine. Then comatose patients, neurogenic bladder, hypotonic bladder and spinal cord injury. Then incontinence of urine. Before surgical intervention of pelvic organ. Acute retention of urine and investigative purpose. Scientific principles. During urinary catheterization procedure, we have to follow some scientific principles, which are first, principle of anatomy and physiology, principle of microbiology, principle of physics, principle of chemistry, principle of psychology, principle of economy, and principle of safety and security. First, we will see principle of anatomy and physiology. Micturition occurs when the muscular wall of the bladder contracts and there is relaxation of internal sphincter and voluntary opening of external sphincter. Temporary, in patient, normal function of sphincter is lost due to catheterization. So, bladder training should be given to patient before removing catheter. Second principle is principle of microbiology. Bladder is the sterile organ. Thus, this procedure is also performed by using strict sterile method to prevent urinary tract infection. Double touch technique also should be used during insertion of catheter to prevent the infection. Third principle is principle of physics. So in that, fluid flows from higher pressure area to lower pressure area under gravity. So place uro bag below bladder level to empty the bladder. And application of lubricant is also essential to reduce the friction between the catheter and the urethra. Fourth principle is principle of chemistry. For the procedure, lignocaine gel, povidone iodine and sodium chloride can be used. So first we will see about lignocaine gel. It is a clear, colorless, sterile and water-soluble gel. It prevents the conduction of sensory nerve impulses near the site of application. It also prevents and controls the pain during insertion of catheter. Next is about povidone iodine. It is an antiseptic used for skin disinfection before catheterization procedure to clean perineal area. Next is 0.9% sodium chloride solution. It is a combination of water and salt which used to inflate balloon of catheter. Usually catheters are available in three types of material: silicone, latex rubber and polyvinyl chloride. We can say PVC also, which is safe for use. Proper selection of catheter material should be done according to patient condition to prevent irritation as well as allergy. Fifth principle is principle of psychology. So in that, explanation of procedure is required to reduce anxiety as well as to gain good cooperation of patient during procedure. Proper draping of patient should be done to prevent embarrassment during procedure and provide privacy to patient with the help of screen. Next principle is principle of economy. Proper time management should be done for procedure. There should not be waste of any solution or any material during procedure. Last principle is principle of safety and security. So in that, minimal force to be applied during insertion of catheter, which can help to prevent injury to urethral mucosa and urethral meatus. No harm should be takes place during procedure. Instruct patient never pull out catheter forcefully. Side rails should be provided to prevent falling out of patient from the bed. Procedure to be done by following nursing laws and ethics. Types of catheter. First image is about condom catheter or external catheter. It consists of a flexible sheet that fits over the penis just like a condom. A condom catheter is a urine storage device that can be used to treat short-term incontinence in men. Second image is about intermittent catheter. It is a straight tube. The insertion and removal of a catheter can be possible several times a day to empty the bladder. Third image is presenting suprapubic catheter. The drainage tube is inserted in urinary bladder through a surgical incision, which is made in the abdominal wall just above the pubic symphysis. Fourth image is about silicone catheter. It contains 100% silicone. They contain no latex, which is ideal for people with latex allergies or sensitivities. Last image is about Foley's catheter. It is a thin, sterile tube inserted into the bladder to drain urine. Because it can be left in place in the bladder for a period of time, it is also called an indwelling catheter. There are mainly four types of Foley's catheter. Here, image denoted with A is female Foley's catheter. Image denoted with B is pediatric Foley's catheter. Image C is presenting two-way or two-lumen catheter. And image D is presenting three-way or three-lumen Foley's catheter. This table is presenting sizes of Foley's catheter according to age and weight. If age is between 0 to 6 months and weight is 3.5 to 7 kg, then 6 French catheter can be used. If age is 1 year with 10 kg weight, then 6 to 8 French. For 2 years age with 12 kg weight, 8 French catheter can be used. For 3 years child with 14 kg weight, 8 to 10 French, and for 5 years child with 18 kg weight, 10 French catheter can be used. For 6 years child with 21 kg weight, 12 French, and for 8 years child with 27 kg weight, 12 French catheter can be used. For 12 years child, sizes of catheter that is varies between 12 to 14 French. For female adult, sizes of catheter that is between 14 to 16 French. And for adult man, sizes of catheter that is between 16 to 18 French. Complications for urinary catheterization are: first, incontinence. Second, infection. Third, sepsis. Fourth, urethral injury. Fifth, skin breakdown. And sixth, hematuria.
Now I will introduce the article for procedure: one clean tray and one sterile tray. One clean tray containing Foley's catheter. Take appropriate size of Foley's catheter for catheterization. Two pair of gloves to maintain the aseptic technique and to prevent the infection. One adhesive tape to fix the catheter. Lignocaine jelly to lubricate catheter. Top sheet to drape the patient. 20 cc syringe to inflate the balloon. Euro bag to collect the urine. Gentle forceps with antiseptic solution. Normal saline to inflate balloon. Iodine solution to clean the genital area. Now we will see about the Foley's catheter. This is 18 French Foley's catheter. There are two types of Foley's catheter: 2 lumen Foley's catheter and 3 lumen. We have 2 lumen Foley's catheter. One lumen, that is for the drainage of urine. Second lumen for the inflating of balloon. So here we can see the parts of catheter. This is the tip of catheter, and here that is the inflating balloon. Third, three lumen catheter, in that third lumen, that is for the irrigation purpose. Next, we will see about the sterile tray. This is the sterile tray which contain two bowl, gauze piece, kidney tray, fenestrated towel and sponge holding forceps. Before starting procedure, first review the physician order, which helps to identify the reason for catheterization. Then identify the patient and assess the patient for time of last voiding, level of awareness, any physical limitation, any pathological condition like in male prostate enlargement, bladder distension, which helps to gain the cooperation of patient during procedure. Next, we will see the patient preparation for the procedure. So first, explain procedure to the patient, which helps to reduce anxiety and promote cooperation during procedure. Then provide privacy with the help of screen to patient, which reduce the embarrassment during procedure. Then stand on the right side of the patient and shift the patient closer to you. That helps to promote the correct body mechanics during procedure. Provide comfortable position to the patient. If female patient, then provide dorsal recumbent positions with slightly externally rotated thighs, and if male patient, provide supine position with abducted thighs. Take Macintosh with draw sheet to prevent the soiling of bed. Then take extra sheet from clean tray. Make a triangle of sheet and place it over patient. As patient is female, provide dorsal recumbent position to patient. If requires, then take the help of assistant to support patient. Then here you can see already I have spreaded extra sheet. One end of the extra sheet, that is covering the genital area. Now with the help of both end of sheet, we have to wrap sheet like this around the patient thigh. So here you can see the draping of the patient. After draping of the patient, we have to go for the hand wash. After hand washing, wear the two pair of gloves. Next, we will see the cleaning of perineal area. If patient is mobile and conscious, then ask patient to wash the perineal area with the help of soap and water before draping. And if patient has some physical limitation, then clean the perineal area with the help of antiseptic solution after draping. With the help of assistant, open the outer layer of sterile tray. Then open the inside layer of sterile tray. Open the lid of sterile tray. Here we can see the articles of sterile tray. One kidney tray, two bowl, gauze piece, sponge holding forceps, fenestrated towel. Next, pour solution into bowl. With the help of assistant, uncover the patient's perineal area. Take sponge holding forceps. Take one gauze piece, soak it into solution clean perineal area first stroke with clitoris to vagina then with non-dominant hand separate labia minora clean labia minora then clean labia majora clean periphery area use single swab for each stroke then last clean from vagina to anus repeat same steps with normal saline after cleaning now with the help of assistant take fenestrated towel and place it over patient Take sterile kidney tray and place it near to perineal area. After this, remove extra pair of gloves. Now we will do the insertion of catheter. For that, take catheter. Assistant will remove the outer cover of catheter. Here you can see inner cover so just we need to touch up to this level and here you can see margin peel out this cover now take lubricant jelly Lubricate tip of catheter. Before insertion of catheter, tell patient to take deep breath if patient is conscious. Then slowly insert catheter into urethral meatus. Once tip of the catheter is inserted, then slowly remove the remaining part of the cover. If female patient, then up to 2.5 to 5 centimeter catheter should be inserted and if male patient then 15 to 25 centimeter catheter should be inserted. Take 20 cc syringe which is filled with normal saline. Now inflate balloon. Slightly pull the catheter. If it is fixed, then it will not come out. To check the placement of the catheter. After insertion of catheter, take Euro bag and connect it with catheter. It should be connected properly so we can prevent the chances of pulling out. Then after this, take out the kidney tray. And remove fenestrated towel. Now remove gloves. And provide comfortable position to the patient. Remove the draping of patient. Cover the patient and expose only required area of the body and fix the uro bag with adhesive tape. Next, tie uro bag below the level of bladder. Replace all the articles and go for the hand washing. Now we have to do recording and reporting. Here we have to write urinary catheterization procedure is done. Patient cooperated well. And output was 100 ml. Then do your signature. I hope all of you have understood the procedure of urinary catheterization. So thank you for watching this video.